relative velocity of a body moving in the opposite direction of motion of another body. In the diagram, body A is moving with velocity vector Va towards right. Another body B is moving in the opposite direction. This is the body B, which is moving with velocity vector Vb in the opposite direction. Now, we can subtract velocity of the body B from the velocity of the body A. In this case, body B was moving towards left. So here we have to consider minus Vb with the velocity of the body A. And for the body B, we can consider minus Vb or opposite velocity of the body B. And this is the actual velocity of the body. Vb is vector Vb is the actual velocity of the body. As a result, the body A will be moving with a relative velocity vector Vab, which will be equal to vector Va plus minus vector Vb. That will be vector Vab. This is the relative velocity of the body A. But as we add minus Vb with Vb vector, that's why velocity of the body B will be zero vector. And we can assume that the body B will be at rest. The body B will be at rest. That means the relative velocity of body A with respect to B can be obtained by imposing equal and opposite velocity of B on both A and B, so that B is brought to rest, and the resultant of two velocities A gives the relative velocity of object A with respect to object B. So finally, the relative velocity of a body moving with a velocity, relative velocity of a body A moving with a velocity vector Va, in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of the another body B, in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of another body B, having velocity vector Vb towards left. Relative velocity of body A moving with velocity vector Va towards right, in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of another body B, having velocity vector Vb, is vector Vab equal vector Va minus vector Vb. Vector Va minus vector Vb. Equal vector Va plus under bracket minus vector Vb, Vb. So this is vector Vab, relative velocity of the body A with respect to relative velocity of the body with respect to the another body B, where the angle between the direction of motion of the two bodies, that is theta equal to 180 degree, which is the angle between the direction of motion of the two bodies moving in the opposite direction. Angle between theta equal to 180 degree is the angle between the direction of motion of the two bodies. Direction of motions of the two bodies. Now we can find the magnitude of vector VAB. So this is a body A, which is moving with velocity vector VA. Another body B is moving with velocity vector VB towards left. So hence the angle between the direction of motion of the two bodies is theta equal to 180 degree. Because vector VB is opposite to vector A. That's why theta equal to 180 degree. Therefore, minus vector VB should be added with vector VA. Is to be added. With vector VA. Therefore, mod vector VAB equals root over mod vector VA square plus mod minus vector VB square plus 2 mod vector A mod minus vector VB cos 180 degree minus theta, where theta is also 180 degree. This is total under square root. Therefore, VAB equal mod vector VAB equal root over VA square plus VB square, because mod minus vector VB is VB. VA square plus VB square minus 2 VA VB cos theta. This is under square root. Now theta is 180 degree. So we can write root over VA square plus VB square minus 2 VA VB cos 180 degree. Where theta is equal to 180 degree and cos 180 degree is minus 1. Hence, we can write this will be root over VA plus VB whole square or VA square plus VB square plus 2 VA VB, because cos 180 degree is minus 1. Therefore, VAB equal VA plus VB. That is the relative velocity of the body A with respect to body B, where two bodies were moving in the opposite directions. VAB equal VA plus VB. Now, if we draw the diagram, a body A and another body is B. Two bodies were moving in the opposite direction. Body A is moving with a velocity vector BA towards right, and body B is moving with a velocity vector BB towards left. Now the body A will appear to move with a relative velocity vector VAB towards right, and we know that VAB is equal to VA plus VB. That's why VAB is greater than VA, and VAB is also greater than VB. Vector VAB is also greater than vector VB, because VAB is equal VA plus VB, and vector VAB is parallel to vector A. That means relative velocity of the body A with respect to B will be in the same direction of vector VA, but in the opposite direction of vector VB. Hence, if two bodies are moving in opposite directions, opposite directions, if two bodies are moving in the opposite directions, the magnitude of the relative velocity of one body with respect to another is equal to the sum of magnitude of their velocities. Magnitude of relative velocity of one body relative velocity of one body with respect to another is the sum of is equal to the sum of magnitude of their velocities So in this expression, in the expression of VAB, VAB equal VA plus VB, that is mod vector VAB equal magnitude of mod vector VA plus mod vector VB. Therefore, if vector VA is antiparallel to vector VB, comma, vector VAB, magnitude of mod vector VAB will be equal to mod vector VA plus mod vector VB. Therefore, VAB equal VA plus VB. So we get VAB as the sum of VA plus VA and VB.